In this video, you'll see how to use LandingLens to train a computer vision model using an open access retinopathy of prematurity dataset. Everything you're about to see was completed in about 30 minutes and improves the F1 score reported by the authors of the paper. This is a multi-class classification project with 5 different classes: normal, stage 1, 2, and 3, and laser scars. After preparing the data, the authors tried many different architectures. We'll be comparing to LandingLens based on the F1 score. Note that the highest value is about 83. Here you see me creating a new project and uploading labeled images for the 5 classes. I've gone through the upload process 3 times so that I could manually set my train, dev, and test splits. You can see the ratios are roughly 80, 10, and 10. And here you see the distribution of the 5 classes. Now it's time to train a model. From the blue drop-down menu, let's choose custom training. I'm happy with the split configuration, so we'll continue on. Here I can choose the epochs and the model size. Under augmentations, I can carefully select which are most appropriate for my use case. I'll add a vertical flip, I'll add a random rotation, and I'll add some variation in the saturation. Then I'll click the train button. I can monitor the model training from the models tab. Model training is done, and we've achieved F1 scores of 99, 96, and 92 on train, dev, and test, respectively. Click on any of these values to access the detailed performance report. Here we're looking at the 114 images in the test set, and we can examine any of the misclassifications. Notice that the model is entirely correct on the normal and the laser scars. Where it makes mistakes is engaging the correct stage of the retinopathy. In these 2 examples, the ground truth is stage 1 and the prediction is stage 2. Use the performance report to examine the misclassifications and make sure that there are no errors in labeling. When you're satisfied with the model, go to the deploy page. Let's create a cloud endpoint for this model. The endpoint has been created, and now we can select which model we want to assign to that endpoint. That was incredibly fast. The model is now ready for inference via API, and we provide starter code for use in Python, JavaScript, or on the command line with curl. If you'd like to run mobile inferences, get the QR code and scan this with your mobile phone. To conclude this video, let's just click Try It Out and use drag and drop. The prediction is stage 1 with a confidence interval of 0.87. Congratulations, you've completed all the steps of your model's first life cycle.